For computing the linear motions for the end effector, we will use the compute underscore Cartesian underscore path API of move group. As arguments, this API takes the waypoints we created above and two other arguments related to the intermediate points that will be created between our waypoints. Let's not worry about those parameters or those arguments. This API also checks for collisions in the trajectory, and this is its default setting. Let's not get into the details of those arguments also. What is important to remember is that this API already considers the current pose of the robot end effector as the starting waypoint. The compute underscore Cartesian underscore path function outputs a plan, which is a trajectory of joint angles, and a fraction, which indicates whether all waypoints were successfully accounted for in the path. If the fraction is smaller than 1, then all waypoints were not successfully accounted for. This can happen due to various reasons, such as collisions or unsuccessful attempts at resolving the joint values for the Cartesian waypoints using inverse kinematics with the TrackIK solver. But usually, these can be also overcome by wrapping up this call in a loop, and usually 3 to 5 attempts are sufficient. All right then, once we have a successful Cartesian motion trajectory, we can update the generated trajectory to the goal message of the action client and send the goal like we do here. And lastly, let's use the set underscore named underscore target API we saw earlier to move the robot to R1 place, which is the location where we will eventually place the hypothetical object for now after picking it, executing the linear motions. Great. Let's see all this in action. So, we switch back to our terminal where we already sourced everything we need. We first start the factory simulation and wait for Gazebo to come up. And there we have our simulation. Then we start the simple pick and place script. As we can see, the robot first moves to the home position, then to pre-grasp, then the linear motion to pick a hypothetical object, and then moves to the place location. This concludes the pick and place pipeline code demonstration.